Well, hello, friends. Welcome. Jump on. Join me for four climbs. It's going to be a fun and hard ride. We'll do four climbs, broken up by four sets of intervals. Back and forth, back and forth. So, you are definitely going to need a sweat towel and a full water bottle. You need a minute to grab those things. Push pause. Get yourself set up. And then settle in. Let's do this. To start us off, easy resistance. 75 RPMs. We've got a two-song warm-up, so we'll go for about 6 minutes, just making sure we're good and warm and ready for our first climb. So before we start to kind of get into technicalities, I just invite you to close your eyes and show up here. You know, when we show up for a cardio workout like this, it's definitely like a box to check. It's a thing to do, to cross off our list. And I would really like to help you make this hour meaningful, so that we learn something while we're burning these calories, while we're strengthening these legs and lungs. We leave our bikes better than when we first sat on them, okay? So I want you to just check in, first of all, with your body. Are there any aches or pains or injuries, conditions that you are aware of? Anything that you want to pay a little extra attention to in your body today, or protect, or strengthen? And then next, bring your attention to breathing in through your nose, out of your mouth, in through your nose, out through your mouth. Slow your legs just a little bit, 70 RPMs. Add a little bit of resistance. All right, so the warm-up continues. Come up into that 7 range, 7 out of 10. Not hard, but not easy. All right, we'll be out of the saddle. Stand up. Relax your hands. Hips touch the saddle, barely. Have a seat. So let's check in with our mental state. What thoughts, what thinking did you show up with this morning? I showed up with a Monday mindset. I've got a million things scheduled, another million to do. Stand up. Mixed with, today is the first day of school for my youngest child, senior year. So I'm showing up with emotions. My last first day of school. So that's my mental load this morning. Emotions, some melancholy, and some stress about all the things. As I just said that last first day of school, I loved school. One of those crazy people. From the very beginning, I loved school. And I remember walking into my high school the first day of my senior year, crying my eyes out because it was my last first day of school. I just made that connection. So, what's happening in your world today? What's that swirl of thinking and feeling? And now that we've noticed body, breath, mental state, let's take all of that. It all gets to be here, but let's put it to work. All right? So here's your first climb. There are four climbs and four sets of sprints. I'm going to let you choose your hard here. So add that a resistance to the wheel. Choose your cadence. I like to hover around 60-65 RPMs when I'm climbing. Music is slower, so this is just kind of moody background sound. We are here for just over 5 minutes. First climb. So settle those hips back. Draw your belly in. So let's just take time to get to where we are. With all of that swirl of emotion and thinking and to-do lists and whatever else, I want to just do a little body scan and have you really be present to what's happening here and now. So with eyes closed, with breath steady, I want you to feel your feet. Toes are wiggly and light inside of your shoe. The ball of the foot is connected to the pedal. You feel that hard sole on the bottom of your shoe and some strength there as you push the pedal forward. Be aware of that. Perfect circles that are pushing forward. Feel your heels relaxed, your ankle relaxed, the top of your foot relaxed. Your feet don't have to work. Your legs are doing the work. Your feet are just connected to pedals. Breathe in. Breathe out. Keep your cadence, whatever that is for you. Hard climb. Bring your attention up your lower leg to your knees. And picture in your mind a piston going up and down, just one going up and then the other. Let your shin bones kind of be like pistons. One up, one down. Your foot stays relaxed. Perfect circles. Bring your attention up to your knee joint, and as much as possible, relax the knee. Joints can't do work. Joints are just what allows the work to happen around the muscles. And the tendons that connect to the bones are causing this joint to bend and extend. So how much ease can you find around your knee joints? You just lighten up that space. Your feet are relaxed. Your lower legs like pistons. And there is space and ease around your knees. Then coming up into the upper legs, this is where we start to feel muscles working. Quadriceps, hip flexors, hamstrings and glutes all working, pushing the pedal forward. All right, folks, stand with me. Stand and climb. Bring it back down. Stay strong in those pedals. Feel your legs from hip crease down to the tips of your toes. Just smooth, like well-oiled machine, creating circles. Stand up. Back down. Stay right here, kids. We're heading into our first set of sprints. We're gonna call this team sprints. So I'm gonna go, and then you're gonna go, and then I'm gonna go, and you're gonna go. Deal? So lighten up resistance. Speed up just a little bit. I will take the first run, 15 seconds, and then you're gonna take the second run, 15 seconds. Keep enough resistance on that you feel strong at about 70 RPMs. All right, I'm gonna go first. Take the first round, you take the second. Here I go. Stand, give it a little bit more, and I'll run for 15. All right, get ready. I'm gonna hand you the baton. You can stand up and sprint. So 15 seconds, I'll slow down. All right, you guys, meet me here. Whew. Okay, we're gonna do that again. I'll go first. You go second, 15 seconds, just a run. Deep breaths, should feel good to start to get some of that sweat going, that heart rate pumping. Sit tall. Add a little. All right, I'm going 15 seconds. Get ready, stand up, go. You got this. And let's sit together. Woo. All right, the next one we'll do together, 30 seconds. It might even be 40, I'm not sure. We're gonna go till the end. We'll go with the music. We'll go with the chorus. Keep that resistance on the wheel. Keep breathing. Let's go breathless, kids. Why am I calling you kids? First day of school. Friends. All right. Let's go. Run. Sprint. Breathless. You got it? So good. Doing what we came to do. Core stays strong. Spine stays tall. I'm all in. Come back down, kids, friends, kids and friends. It's stuck in my brain. Whew. All right. Guess what? Climb number two. That's how we'll do this ride. Climb sprint. We've got one set down. We've got three to go. Whew. Please hydrate. So once again, I'd like you to add resistance so this already feels challenging. Set your cadence. Not really a driving beat from the music. We'll be up and down. We'll keep adding resistance. Hard hill. We're here for just over 5 minutes. You can pedal anywhere between 60 and 80 RPMs. I'm hovering right around 75. Let's add resistance. Stand it up. Same cadence, same resistance. Engage. From the waist down, everything's working well. Strong muscles, relaxed joints. Come back down. Keep your pace. Feel into your hip joint. Same thing, ease of movement there. Even though the muscles, you feel muscles working, but imagine those bones, that ball and socket, moving with ease. Sweat it out. It should feel like an 8 on a scale of 1 to 10. Let's add a little. Come on up. Whew. Good times, huh? Hard work. This is what you came for. Down. Get behind your pedals so the hips are way back. Pelvis is light. There's ease of movement around the hips, the knees, ankles. Fill up with breath. Let it go. Let's add resistance. Stand up. Same cadence, same effort. different position. Back down. Hold on to it. Whew. How's your breath? How's your body? Is your head clearing? Are you just starting to feel that fog lift? We're 20 minutes in right now, and I always notice right about now a shift. Endorphins, energy, sweat. It takes your body about 20 minutes of consistent work to get warm enough that your body starts to utilize fat as a fuel. So fat is as energy source is converted to fatty acid, which is a source of energy that your body can use. So whether it came in the form of your diet recently or it's stored somewhere, your body can be more efficient with it right now. So we got that going for us. Are you ready for intervals? All right, so here's what we'll do. We'll let our song get started. We'll add some resistance. We'll get out of the saddle. Our intervals will be in the saddle, sprinting. So the rest, although it won't feel much like rest, is walking or jogging. So let's kind of let this build. We've got a little over 3 minutes, so it's not too long. All right, mentally prepared for some work. You've got enough resistance on the wheel. Stand up. About 70 RPMs. Are you ready? Have a seat. Accelerate. Go faster. Go as fast as you can, up to 100 RPMs, as close as you can get. Give yourself this gift. Aggressive. Come on, stay with it. Stay aggressive. 4, 3, 2, slow it down. Stand up, walk it out. Oh yeah, that was fun, wasn't it? Are you breathless like me? Ooh, happy Monday. Whatever the heck day it is you're doing this, hope you're feeling it. That surge of energy. Sweat. So we're gonna do it again. Sit when the music explodes and we'll accelerate. Have a seat. Let's go. Start to accelerate. There's a little urgency here, right? You feel that? An urgency. Come on. Stay with it. We're almost through this one. Come on, urgency, aggressive. Get as close to 100 RPMs as you can. Breathless. Keep it going. Keep it going. keep breathing, even though you're breathless. I know that's weird. Slow your legs. Whew. We did it. And we are halfway through. Two sets down, two sets to go. We're heading to hill number three. All right, friends, this one is entirely in the saddle. It's almost 7 minutes. Every minute, we're gonna add resistance. So that'll be about five adds. So if you start out with it already hard, it should be extra hard when you add five more little touches or quarter turns to the wheel. Okay? All right, we've got some slow-mo here. About 60 RPMs. And you got good stuff on the wheel. You're breathing. You're settled in. Noticing all of it. Physical, mental, energy, emotion. Here's our first add. A quarter turn or whatever your bike feels like is a little addition. All right. Folks, scooch back in the saddle, close your eyes again, relax your upper body. Bring your awareness to the base of your pelvis. And I want you to lift those muscles up so you feel a little lighter in the saddle. Pull your navel in and up, almost like there's a string lifting you up away from the saddle. You're still seated, but you're light. You're taut, you're strong, you're buoyant. Shoulder blades down your back. Here comes your second add. Whatever that means on your bike and with your body, a little add. Steady breath. In through the nose, out through the mouth. She came at me in sections with the eyes of desire. Trapped under a web of sin. A touch, a kiss, a whisper of love. A great time to just really relax your face, your jaw, your forehead, your neck. We hold so much tension up here. Let this time be relaxing for the parts of the body that don't need to work. Let's add again. That's our third add. That should start to be really challenging to those muscles in your legs. Sit light, lift up, engage. Relax your shoulders. Feel your elbows just soft, bent, your hands light. Chest lifts forward, shoulders relax. Steady breath, in through the nose, out through your mouth. Breathe in, breathe out. I cannot sleep alone at night. My baby left me again tonight. I cannot cope till it's all right. You break your neck, you break it. You turn my baby.
And then it happened. She touched me. For the lips of a strange woman dry as a honeycomb.
So back down to your toes, relax your feet again. They take a lot of tension when we're not thinking about it. Reassess. How's your body? What are you aware of right now physically? Be here now, feel this. Let's add number four. That should feel very close to impossible. It'd be really like sludgy, muddy, thick resistance. Notice a tendency to round your back when you get a lot of resistance, kind of to brace against. I'd like you to lift up out. Stay tall. Let your legs do the work. Keep breathing, come on. I know this is our longest hill. So strong, so powerful. Reach down and feel your hamstrings. Every time you push the pedal forward, that's when your hamstrings are working. They're helping to extend the hip. They're working with the glutes. They're not working to pull the pedal up. The other foot does that. So get that emphasis in front. Push forward. Last add right here. Last add, we're almost there. Oh, slow and heavy. Woo! All right, friends, are you ready for intervals? Short song, about 4 minutes. We'll go 30, 30. 30 seconds fast, 30 seconds slower. Oh, like my legs are going, I don't know about this. All right, lighten up some of that resistance. Come back to moderate, not too much, not too little. All right, here we go. 65 RPMs, 30 seconds slow, 30 seconds fast. We'll do that 4 times. And then we'll hit our final set. Who is excited? Me. I'm proud of us. We are well past the halfway mark. We're on our way to the finish line. Very proud of both of us for being here today and doing this. Are you ready? Add a little. Accelerate. 30 seconds. The goal is breathless on these, so if you don't have enough resistance, add some more. We want to challenge that anaerobic system. Sit light. 4, 3, 2, slow it down again. All right, recover, drink, breathe, do whatever you need to do. Come back down. All right, check in, body, breath, mental state. Is exercise working? Ready? Let's go, come on. You can close your eyes and just get into the mechanics of this. The machine, physical working, all the systems in tandem. Fascinating when you think about heart, lungs, muscles, circulation, joints, tissue. Whew. Energy. 4, 3, 2, slow it down. Sit tall, be strong. Whew. Alrighty. We say we do that 2 more times.
engage. Ready, set, let's go. We got this. Go as hard and fast as you can, with control, with resistance. Keep it up, keep it up. Four, three, two, slow down. One more time. Oh. Happy, good times. One more push, everybody, 30 seconds. Who's with me? Let's go. Come on, don't stop now. Don't stop now. Finish strong. Never ever give up on yourself. Four, three, two, and one. Okay, let's climb. Hips are back. This is our final hill. This is our final climb. Nothing fancy here. Your choice though, seated or standing. We've got just under 5 minutes on our final hill, and we're at 65 RPMs. So as long as you're staying 65 and you've got the resistance on the wheel, drive this your way. Sit when you want, stand when you want. Just make sure you have hard effort. 8 out of 10. I don't know if you've noticed or not, this is a whole ride of hard to breathless, hard to breathless, hard to breathless. Kind of sneaks up on you, doesn't it? Look at those calories. Woo! Worth it. Especially this close to the finish line. So let's use these final 3 minutes to go back inside, and let's check back in with that mental state. So all of those like to-do lists, pressures and stresses, I mean, those are not the end of the world. They get annoying and they can cause us more stress because we're always future thinking. But the thoughts below those are worrisome to me. And these tend to be those, that internal dialogue of, I am not blank enough. Or I'm too blank. So just indulge. And as you run the movie, as you run the tape, is there any of that going on in the back of your mind? I'm too old for that. I'm too fat. I'm too tired. I'm too lazy. I'm too whatever, forgetful, fill in the blank. And perhaps that had been told to you by someone else long ago, and it just caught on and dug a deep root, and there it is, kind of a tape running in the background, and to whatever. And maybe it's more like, I'm not enough, fill in the blank. I'm not thin enough, I'm not rich enough, I'm not tall enough, I'm not smart enough. I'm not like her or him or that, right? Social media, for example, from here in despair. Just notice if you have any of those old tired tapes running in the back of your mind. Too blank, not enough blank. And I'm going to suggest that we take our final set of intervals and we treat this kind of like a big whiteboard eraser, and we start to erase those old lies, because they are lies, they're not true. The bottom line is, you are enough, you are worthy of love and belonging, you are up for the task of your own life, you're worthy of joy, you're worthy of freedom and play. Worthy. And if we just erase that whiteboard, you can put a Sharpie in your hand or a dry erase marker, and you can write whatever you want on that board. I am, and you fill in the blanks. You're the author. And whatever you declare again and again and again and again, you know this becomes truth to you, and thus truth in your life. So let's erase the whiteboard here. We have 2 60-second intervals ahead of us, and then a nice long taper and stretch. All right? So what I'd like you to do is get started. 65 RPMs. Let's get up out of the saddle. Add some resistance. The 60 seconds will happen in the saddle with resistance twice. So, relax, get all those joints back to ease. Clear your mind with a big exhale. Come here now. These 2 60-second intervals are whiteboard erasers. Erasing negative self-talk from the whiteboard in your brain. Are you ready? Have a seat. Accelerate. Picture that board with all of that dialogue that's been going on for all these years, and just, it's so satisfying to clear a whiteboard. Just watch yourself across big strokes. Doesn't even matter, you're not even reading the words anymore. You're just creating a white slate in front of you. Just do it. Sometimes you have to get out that spray because you've got one that's a little stuck. Get out the spray, scrub a little bit. And in front of you, you're gonna see a giant, wide open space whiteboard. Get in the corners, wipe it all clean, and slow your roll. Come back to 65 RPMs. So check back into this moment. Feel your body. Feel your breath. Feel your energy. You have one more 60-second sprint, and on this one, I want you to imagine you have brand new dry erase markers. You can smell them, right? You can tell me about the supplies. Yeah. All right. Brand new. And you're going to grab several, right, in different colors. And in 60 seconds, I want you to write. So at the top of the board, it already says, I am. And I want you to write as many words as you can that might not feel true to you right now, but they're going to be true because you're going to say them so many times between now and the end of the day that they're going to start to feel like absolute truth. Ready? Accelerate. Close your eyes. Get out your dry erase markers and write. I am. Keep writing, keep writing. I am. Make sure you include the word worthy and enough. Keep writing, keep writing. Fill the board with new messages. I am. Three, two, one, slow it down. Whew. Oh, my friends. Now that's gonna be your homework, you know this, right? To get a real whiteboard. It also works well to write on a mirror with dry erase. So maybe like your bathroom mirror is a great place for that exercise. Start by cleaning it really good, symbolic of erasing old messaging, old conditioning. You know what I mean by that. Roll resistance off and just let your legs float. I'm gonna taper down a little bit here before we start to stretch. Take about a minute to let the heart rate drop. So we live in a society that functions best when we stay inside our boxes. And we all have boxes that we have been put in by other people originally and then by ourselves. We keep ourselves locked up, right? We are our own jailer. We take on these roles and we believe them to be, you know, sometimes our only options. Slow the legs even more. And go ahead and sit tall. Shake out your hands. So, for example, when you were young, what were you told about yourself? So lift up. You were the nice one, or the funny one, or the smart one, or the overachiever one. You were a leader. You were a good team player. Go ahead and grab behind, stretch. Right? And those are all great compliments and good things to be. And then 40 years later, do you find yourself only being able to be that? Right? Reach the arms high, bend your legs, press the palms to the ceiling, stretch. So I can only be the good girl and color and size aligned. I can only be the nice one and never offend. I can only be the funny one and never allow to feel sad or angry or upset. Roll your shoulders. Let's go ahead and come up onto the handlebars. Balls of the feet on the pedals. Feel your calves stretching and then shift your hips back to find hamstrings. I'd like you to just do that work, right? Erasing the whiteboard. So for me, oldest child, for a lot of reasons, I ended up being the responsible one, right? The overachiever, the leader. Go ahead and switch and shift back. And so that served me well in capacities like this. I can lead, I can teach, I can instruct, I can mentor. I'm really good at it. And many times in my life, the exact opposite of that same skill is my weakness, which is I'm not a really good team player. I'm hard to be a partner with, right? Hard, probably hard to be married to me. I'm bossy and I'm right. You know, so like looking at what is the way that we think we have to be, and is there another way? Like, I want to be more playful and have more just like simplistic joy in my life. And that's really hard for me because I think I have to be like this way. Go ahead and step off the bike. So take your feet wide. Let's shift hips to one side and take that same arm up and over. Stretch the whole side of your body. We're erasing the whiteboard. We give ourselves more choice. You know? Switch sides. So hopefully your body feels better. So you're breathing a little more easily. Your mind is a little more clear. Let's take one leg and just lean out. Put a nice big range of motion and then hold that leg back in your hand. If that doesn't feel good, keep it on the floor, but just stretch here across hip flexor and quads. Press down into your standing leg and get really tall. All that space. Hold that breath. And go ahead and switch, swing out the other leg. I feel 7,000 times better now than when we showed up here today. I was kind of a bundle of emotion and stress, and it's kind of all still here, that I just feel more equipped to be in my body and to do what I need to do today. I hope you feel the same. Let's take the feet wide, reach back, interlace, open up one more time through the whole front of the body, little back bend, and then hinge from the hips. Drop your head, lift your fingers. A little bit of blood flow to your brain, clarity. Knees really bent, hands on the thighs. I'll turn sideways, arch your back and round. Stand cat and calf. So if you need a reminder throughout your day, just keep reminding back to this. My friend, you are enough. You are worthy of love and belonging. You're worthy of experiencing joy. And I just wish all of that for you. Please, please, please do your homework. Just do that mental exercise of erasing the whiteboard and creating some new, in yoga we call them samskaras, some new like ditches that we get stuck in, like thinking ditches. Why not get stuck in a positive ditch, right? I am worthy, I am enough, I am smart, I'm strong, I'm capable, I'm healthy, right, and loving. So please take all of that with you today. And have a freaking fantastic day. I'll see you next time.
Hi friends, just want to say thank you so much for joining me here for these workouts. If you like what you find here, make sure to subscribe, give me a thumbs up, and I love when you leave comments. Let's keep working out together. We will make our world and the world a better place.